Hello and welcome to Sportskeeda's transfer market discussion. We're now going to be discussing Chelsea, how they have done in the transfer window so far, and what they need to do next. Chelsea have already purchased Jorginho from Napoli, who could be a very, very good signing. He's definitely going to complement their midfield, especially, you know, alongside N'Golo Kante.
I mean, retrieving the ball from Chelsea or keeping it away from them is going to be an even tougher task if it could get any harder. I mean, N'Golo Kante, what he lacked in the last season was a good defensive midfielder to like share the midfield with, because Matis had departed for United. And with Jorginho, they get exactly that. A tenacious defender, a defensive midfielder who's always after the ball. And he is technically a brilliant player. I mean, if you look at it, I think the only weakness he probably has is the fact that he is short in stature. And as a result, he might get dominated in aerial duels. Other than that, I guess he's a very good passer of the ball. He can hold on to the ball well. He can pick those defense splitting passes as well. And you know, with Kante behind him, he can also explore his, you know, attacking side of the game. And I guess it's great news for Chelsea that they've signed Jorginho. And
I mean, he certainly is a very good buy, but Chelsea's biggest concern right now will definitely be the fact that, you know, clubs are looking at Hazard and Courtois, and both of them have been linked with a number of clubs, especially Real Madrid. And we know for a fact that Real Madrid, at the end of the day, they get what they want. And if even one of these two leave, Chelsea will be left with a massive void that they'll have to fill. And regardless of, you know, who they get as a replacement, it won't come cheap, might not be as good. How do you think they should tackle that problem?
I don't know. It just seems like Chelsea have a lot of problems right now, because Willian is set to leave. Hazard and Courtois have made their intentions clear. I mean, they've said like they've had their time in Chelsea. It was good. Time to move on.
And looks like they all want to follow Conte out the door.
And, you can't replace a player like Hazard at Chelsea. I mean, he's too. Even at the World Cup, he was brilliant.
I think he was easily one of the best players at the World Cup, undeniably.
And so Eden Hazard needs to be replaced, and you can't expect Willy Caballero to, like, you know, step up and fill Courtois' shoes. So another great goalkeeper signing, maybe, but I don't know if they need to go out in the market and like get things done very fast, I guess, because Thibaut Courtois has reportedly already agreed terms with Real Madrid. I mean, nothing's been finalized between the clubs, but Courtois is ready to leave, is what we know.
But look, even for their the deals going outward, they need to finalize it quickly, because if it is a deadline day transfer, they have literally no time to, you know, get replacements for them. Courtois, the latest reports say Courtois has agreed terms, which is probably good in a way for Chelsea, because they still have some time, you know, to get a replacement. Hazard, they've been very tight-lipped about it. They're very hesitant to let him go, understandably. I mean, he is by far their best player. And without him, this Chelsea might not even look the same anymore.
And Chelsea have also been linked with Daniel Rugani, Juventus. He's a very calm-headed defender. Sarri's worked with him before. And, you know, he's the kind of player who is basically what Chelsea need right now, because, you know, it just feels like Chelsea, Gary Cahill has faded, and you know, Rudiger has his days, but then every once in a while he tends to falter, and Daniel Rugani can shore up that defense. I guess other than that, so Chelsea have quite a few problems to address, and the sooner they address it, the better for them. But other than that, I guess the midfield concerns are pretty much taken care of as it stands with Jorginho.
So to sum it up, Chelsea's biggest problems aren't the players that they need to sign. It's about the players that they need to keep. They need to retain a number of their stars who look like they're heading out of the door. So unlike most other clubs who are looking to buy players, Chelsea's will be, you know, just to keep them at the club. Well, that's it for this discussion. Does the club need any other signings? Should they let go of anyone? Get in on the action and tell us what you think in the comments below. Like, share and subscribe to Sportskeeda for more.